Today, I am here to discuss a numerical on journal bearing, or you can say sliding contact bearing. So the given data is radial load, that is 5000 Newton, RPM is 1000 Newton, atmospheric temperature is 25 degrees centigrade, and T0, that means oil film temperature, is 77 degrees C. A hint is given, that means a type of oil and oil ring, that means it is a type of oil which is used for lubricating purpose. So here I am with step number 1. So in case of journal bearing, the first step is to determine the ratio of L by D. So here L is the length of the bearing and D is the diameter of a journal or shaft. So both L and D is not given, since the journal is made of hardened steel and the bearing is made of bronze backed babbitt bearing. That is, this type of material, that means bronze backed and hardened steel, is widely used in IC engine, especially automobiles. So here only a given data, that means with the help of given data, that is bronze backed bearing and another is hardened steel, with the help of these two I came to conclusion that it will be used in IC engine. So from page number 364, I am referring design data book Mahadevan, and refer page 366 for L by D ratio, that is 1.6. In general case, if nothing is mentioned, then assume L by D between 1 to 2. So I am assuming here as 1.6. Now step number 2 is permissible bearing pressure. Permissible bearing pressure I have used from the same page number, that is 366, and it is equal to 9.3 Newton per mm square. Moving on to third step, that is bearing dimension. Bearing dimension mean to say diameter of journal or shaft, and small l will be the length of the bearing. So P is equal to W divided by projected area. Projected area means L into D. Here L into D is 537.63 and L by D is 1.6. From these two equation, I came to conclusion that D should be 18.33, and we will take it as 20 mm. So if D is 20 mm, then L will be 32 millimeter. Now there is a check that bearing pressure, I have already mentioned, P is equal to W divided by L into D. If W is equal to 5000 Newton and L into D is this one, then it is coming 7.8125 Newton per mm square. That means, which is less than 9.3 Newton per mm square. That means whatever the value I have assumed from the design data book here, that it must be less than the taken value. That means whatever the calculated value comes, that is 7.812, that is less than assumed value. Hence, we are assuming design as safe. Moving on to the next step. Step number 4. Step number 4 is to find the value of viscosity. Since the bearing is lubricated by oil rings, that means this has already been given in the question. That means with the help of page number 363, there is a term SAE, that means Society of Automotive Engineers. Here, in that case, the density, specific gravity at 15 degrees centigrade is 0.8894. We will take the formula from page number 352, ZK. ZK is the kinematic viscosity at 77 degrees centigrade. At 77 degrees centigrade, from the page number 352, there is a graph between temperature and kinematic viscosity. We will find at 9 centistoke. We will convert into meter square per second, that means 9 divided by 10 to the power 6, and it finally comes 9 into 10 to the minus 6. Now moving on to specific gravity of oil at 77 degrees centigrade. So for 77 degrees centigrade, why? Because it is given in question. We have taken formula from the design data book, and it is from page number 350. This one is kinematic viscosity. We must be focused on dynamic viscosity. So we will convert this kinematic viscosity into dynamic viscosity, taking the reference of a specific gravity at 15 degrees centigrade and 77 degrees centigrade. So for 77 degree specific gravity should be this one and this much. Dynamic viscosity is equal to ZK, that means kinematic viscosity, into rho into row 77, that means row 77, mean to say 77 is the temperature, and finally it comes 7.65 into 10 to the minus 3 newton second per meter square. Moving into radial clearance. Radial clearance here is small c. We will move to page number 367. It is 3.5 into 10 to minus 3. Look, hence we are designing all the term. We have to assume the data. Especially three things are given in the question, that is load, that is temperature, and type of lubricant. And with the help of these three, we will be able to find the value of, or we will be able to design the general contact bearing. So R by C, R is already given, is 10 mm, since diameter is 20 mm, and this is this much. So F is called the coefficient of friction, and we will be able to find with the help of Mackey's equation. Mackey's equation says this one, and it is equal to 2.76 into 10 to the power minus 3. So this is called the coefficient of friction. And coefficient of friction, after calculating coefficient of friction, we will be able to find the value of a heat generated. Step number 6-7, Hg is equal to FVW. F is called coefficient of friction. V is equal to pi dN by 16 to 1000. Remember, this should be in millimeter. So Hg is equal to 114.45 joule per second. Now moving on to heat dissipation. Heat dissipation KH into A dash into TB minus TA. TB minus TA is equal to half of T0 minus TA. T0 is called oil film temperature. TA is called atmospheric temperature. It is 26 degrees centigrade. Area is equal to 20 dL. 20 here, I am assuming this equation from data book again. So data book is very much important in calculation of general contact bearing numerical. A dash is equal to this much. Again KH is equal to, it's a factor, and it is equal to 15.3 joule per second meter square degree centigrade. Z HD, that means heat dissipation, is equal to 5.091 joule per second or what. So if HG is greater than HD, that means heat generation is greater than HD, therefore the bearing should be redesigned. That means whatever the generated heat comes out is greater than heat dissipation. That means we have to redesign the bearing, or the bearing should be cooled artificially. That means you have to cool the bearing with the help of some external agent. So if it is HD is less than, then we have to find the value amount of artificial cooling. Amount of artificial cooling is nothing but HG minus HD. It is 9.539. And once we able to find the value amount of artificial cooling, then mass of cooling oil has to be find out, and it is equal to Hg minus Hd is equal to mcp delta t, and finally mass is equal to 0.0311 kg per minute. So these are the design steps. Step 1, L by D ratio. Again I am recalling, step 1, L by D ratio. Step 2 is called your bearing pressure. Step 3, bearing dimensions. Step 4, in step 3 we will have to check. Step 4, that is dynamic viscosity. Step 5, radial clearance. Step 6, it is coefficient of friction. After calculating coefficient of friction, it is step number 7, that is Hg, and Hg, that is heat generated. Then after heat dissipation, we have to compare from heat generation and heat dissipation, that which one is greater. And suppose if HD was greater than HG, then in that case we will find the value of design that will be safe. In that case we no need to find the value of amount of artificial cooling and mass of cooling oil. Since in this case HG is greater than HD, then we will have to find this value. I hope you got my point. So in the coming lecture I will bring you another type of numerical. Thank you so much.